Okay, Jesus Christ, you're listening to Drive Time. This is February 28th, the Dinner Time edition. I don't know when the hell I'm going to get around to publishing all of this crap, but this is the nighttime edition of a three-time daily thing that I'm trying to do, which I'll probably end up deleting everything if I can't get it together. This is the weather is... It's a nice night. It's I guess it's a little cloudy, but it's warm for February. This being the last day in February, I got to drop my dog. Got to get going to get my doggy. Getting pick my dog and get some grub. It's Thursday night. Itching for the weekend. What are you gonna do? It's February 28th. This is what life is coming down to. It's just a series of days, one after the other. You put your best foot forward. Put your best foot forward and your best pair of slacks or overalls on, and you just keep swinging for the fences. I think another reason to do this is that you just it's like doodling. Like, my brain can't stop, so it's like, why try and stop it? Maybe I'll latch onto something. Some idea will pop into the head. So by forcing myself to talk and kind of ramble, really, it's a rambling. It's a mad lunatic rambling is what this program really is. But to force yourself to do that is good, I think. In a weird way, I think it's a good thing, because it's drawing. It's drawing. Because what is drawing, if not a means to another piece of art? All right, let's get into some good stuff here in the evening. What do I want to talk about? What do I want to say? Can't have too many big gaps. You can't have too many big gaps. Mind the gaps. Mind the gaps in your ocean. Imagine that. Imagine an ocean. Think about an ocean, but instead of islands or masses of land, if there was something else, like holes in the ocean. So the ocean stopped, and almost like it was like a cavern wall, like a mountainside. You can't think of something like that because we don't have the necessary starting point. You can't really think of water standing still against, obviously, I guess it's people have thought of that. It's been in movies, like water just like suspended in a room or in a space, and you like poke at it like a water wall. I don't know. I'm trying here. I really am. But I've done it. I've done it this time. The anxiety I brought it upon myself, and I'm trying hard. I'm trying my fucking hardest to break down mentally, I think. Pushing myself to some sort of a natural brink of lack of sleep. And the thing is, I sleep well now, but this is what's funny about it is by filling up, packing my days so full, it tires me out. And then, on top of it, I've been running a lot more. And that is definitely a great sleep aid. If anyone out there is having issues sleeping, try working out, try running, run long distance. Long distance running, I found, is the key to that. And I don't know if I didn't do that. I didn't do that today, and I'm actually taking a day off because my weary muscles need a day off. So I think I need to do that. As much as you can get into the habit of running all the time, it's also good to just not run. Because then the tomorrow run will be better. I'm trying to do an 11-mile run. 11 miles! 11-mile run! I'm an extreme individual. I'm like an extreme human being. So many unrealized projects and projects that aren't quite happening the way I want them to. that's what it's all about. That is, that'll be my legacy if I have one. Will be the you know, and not that I've, you know, look, I'm a person here, man. I'm just a person in the world. Nothing. I am not special. I'm not an individual. I'm not looking, you know, I'm not trying to be famous. I'm trying to make sense. I go to work. I go out to eat. My parents. I don't need my parents. I got a dog. Take my dog out. My dog poops. Pick up the poop. Put the poop in the garbage. What else, you know? I just, you know, it's just, I happen to enjoy doing this. I think it's enjoyment. I don't know. If I could turn it off, if I could find a way to turn it off, and the urge to be creative could just disappear, you know, would that bring some sort of, you know, a different kind of happiness that I haven't experienced yet? Like an acceptance of, like, oh, you don't need to create things. And maybe you know what it is. Maybe it's the internet. Is the internet is the problem? Because I don't know. I think if I just started making things and then didn't have the if I didn't know they were going to be seen by 1 to 7 people on average, who are not me, and I just would it, and I still did everything the same. I made all the things and then just didn't post them online. So they were just things that I was, you know, hoarding digitally somewhere. All right, well, here's another thing. That, at this point, that, you know, that becomes, it becomes an issue of just, I don't have the space for all that. I've literally outcreated my hard drive by a good deal. So I don't, a lot of the stuff that is on YouTube or other locations, I don't have it anymore. Like, that's where it exists. I delete it when I'm done uploading it. So, answered my own question. I was going to end the show right there, but this guy almost killed me, so I should probably just reflect on that for a moment as I'm pulling into my stop here. Oh, Jesus Christ, I got these boxes in my back of my car. I got to move them to get the dog in. I took the dog out first before we go to. I'm gonna be late for dinner. Yep. It's all happening.